Now again, this is the basic TTL NOT gate which we have already discussed. This is the basic circuit. The temple output again driven by transistor, and this transistor again driven by another transistor. Up to now we have seen TTL NOT gate, we have seen TTL NAND gate also. Now we are going to see how TTL NOR gate is designed. Same basic circuit of TTL inverter is here. Only some modifications have to be done and then it will work like a NOR gate. See, first what we have to do? We have to connect a transistor parallel to transistor T2. How? That means the collector of this transistor is taken, its emitter is again taken, and we have to connect a transistor like this that the emitter of the connected transistor should be connected to emitter, and collector of this transistor should be connected to collector of transistor T2. That means it will create a parallel connection. In the same way, how T1 and T2 was connected, this transistor's configuration should be done in the same way. That means to the base of this transistor, another transistor is collectors is connected. In the same way, we will connect. This is the base of this transistor, that means like T2, and it is connected to collector of another transistor. In this way, so collector to base, again collector to base. So there is another connection. Now, again, in the same way, how 4 kilo ohm resistor was connected to the base of this transistor, in the same way, another 4 kilo ohm resistor has to be connected here, and that should be connected to the base of this new transistor. The emitter of both the transistor, now, they will form the inputs for this circuit. So this will be A input and this will be for B input. Now this is for only two input NOR gate. We can construct it for more inputs also. We have to make same type of connection. That means again a parallel transistor has to be connected, and that transistor has to be connected to drive the this transistor. Another transistor will be connected to 4 kilo ohm resistor. So we can have many connections or many inputs to this NOR gate. We are only considering only two inputs NOR gate, so that is why we have taken only two inputs. Now we have already named them T1, T2, T3, T4. Let us name these T5 and T6. So this will work like a NOR gate. Now you know NOR gate's Boolean equation is given by A plus B whole complement. So if the inputs are 2, there will be possibility of 4 combinations of logic levels. That means either they will be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 or 1, 1. NOR gate is a combination of OR gate and then a NOT gate. That means first of all, the inputs are sum is taken or added. We will get A plus B at this point, and this will be complemented later by NOT gate. So it will form A plus B whole complement. So if you add them, 0 plus 0 will be 0 and 0's complement will be 1. 0 plus 1 is 1 and 1's complement will be 0. 1 plus 0 is 1 and 1's complement will be 0. Again, 1 plus 1 is 1 and 1's complement will be 0. So this is the output for NOR gate. So addition and then complement is done by a gate, and that gate is called a NOR gate. So it is the combination of OR gate and NOR gate. Starting to explain this, we have to consider this condition one by one. Let us consider the first condition, that means A is connected to 0 and B is connected to 0. To connect this input to logic 0, we have to connect it towards ground. So here let's start from transistor T1. Transistor T1's emitter is connected to ground. So there is a diode between base to emitter, and diode's base is P-type and emitter is N-type. In the same way T5 also, this is connected to positive terminal. So diode's base is P-type and emitter is N-type. So N type is connected to ground and P type is connected to plus VCC. In the same way, transistor T1 also. Starting from T1, T1 is the base to emitter between our transistor T1. It's connected to positive terminal and it is connected to ground. So this diode will be followed by, if this diode will be followed by all the current from the base, it will sink towards ground through point A. So this transistor will be on. Same connection is done with the transistor T5. So all the current will from the base to emitter will conduct and it will sink towards ground. So this transistor is also on. So in this case, when A is equal to 0, B equal to 0, T5 and T1, both the transistors are on. If these transistors are on, all the current from the plus VCC, it will sink towards ground. So no current will flow towards the collector of both the transistors. So here, at the base of T6 and base of T2, the voltages are low. If the voltages at the basis of transistor are low, then the transistor will be off. That means T6, it will be off, and T2, it will be also off. If the transistors are off, then the collector voltage or the current at the collector voltage, it will stop here and it will not conduct towards the emitters of this transistor. So there will be high voltage at the collector and low voltage at the emitters. High voltage at the base of transistor T3, it will turn on this transistor T3. So in this case, transistor T3 is on. In the same way, diode B, it will be also followed by. So all the current from the plus VCC can easily pass towards this point. But low at the base of transistor T4, it will turn on this transistor to off condition. If it is off, then no current will pass throughout the transistor T4, so it will not conduct. So the possible conduction path will be towards the LED. So all the current will flow towards the LED and this LED will glow, and it will show that high output at the output. So Y equal to 1 we are getting at the output because T4 is off. We have started from A equal to 0, B equal to 0, we are getting 1 at the output. So first condition is satisfied. Now the next condition, A equal to 0 and B equal to 1. If B equal to 1, that means logic level is, binary level is 1, that means it should be connected to plus VCC. So that is why B is connected to plus VCC. Now see, this condition is same as that of the previous condition. So emitter is connected to N type, P is connected to positive type. So that is why this diode will be on or forward bias. So that is why this transistor is still on. Back to second transistor, plus VCC is connected to N type and plus VCC again connected to P type. So both the terminals of diodes, they are connected to same polarity. So that is why no current will flow or no current will conduct. So that is why this transistor will be off. So T5 is off in this case. So all the current will flow towards collector. So that is why it will create high voltage at the collector of transistor T5 as it is off. What about this transistor? It will create low voltage at the collector because it is on. So all the current is flowing towards this direction. So no current, so it will be low. T6 and T2 are connected between parallel connection. So we can consider that these are the two switches, they are connected in parallel, in which T6 will be on because there is a high voltage at the base of T6 and it will turn on the base to emitter connection, and overall the transistor will be on. So T6 is on and T2 is off here. From the two parallel connections, you can see that there is a steel path present to conduct the current towards the ground. So if this path is off, another path is on, so that is why all the current will stay, it is flowing towards ground. So if the current between the two parallel connections, it is conducting, there will be no voltage at will be stopped here or low current is stopped here, so that is why there will be no voltage drop across this point. So this will create low at the input of base of transistor T3. Now If the current is conducting here, then the same current will conduct towards the resistor, through the resistor. So 1 kilo ohm will have the voltage drop, and this voltage we will consider as high voltage, because this voltage is more than that of the 0.7 volts. So we can say that the voltage is high. Now base permitter of transistor T4, it is getting high voltage, so that is why it will be on. Base permitter of transistor T3, it is low, so it will be off. So if in the series connection this switch is off, so no current will flow up to this point. If some current is there, that will be again seen towards ground, because T4 is on. So if no current is there, this LED will not glow. And if this LED is not glowing, we can consider that the output is at low voltage. So output is low in this case. What we have started, we have connected A input to ground and B input to the switch system. That means A is 0 and B is 1. What we are getting? We are getting 0 at the output. So second condition is satisfied here. Now the third condition. In third condition, A is connected to plus VCC. And B is connected to ground. Now the connections will be changed in the previous condition. Now this transistor, it is connected to plus VCC. Both the diodes terminals are connected to plus VCC. So that is why this transistor will be off. It will create high at the collector. Now for transistor T5, it is connected to ground, so P-type is connected to positive terminal and N-type is connected to ground. That means this diode will be forward biased, and if diode is forward biased, we can say that the transistor is conducting. If this transistor is conducting, all the current will sink towards ground through B terminal, and there will be no voltage at the collector, so that is why output at the output of transistor T5 we will get low voltage. High will turn on transistor T2, and low at the base of transistor T6 it will be turn off the transistor T6. Again they are connected in parallel, so one of the path is still on and another is off. Still the current from the 1.6 kilo ohm resistor, it will flow towards the ground. So if the all the current is sinking, there will be no voltage drop across this. So low at the collector of T2 will be present, and high voltage at the emitter of this transistor will be present here. Low at T3 will make transistor T3 off, and high at the transistor T4 will make on this transistor. So if the switch connected here, if this is off, no current will flow there. So Y equal to output equal to 0 and LED will not glow. So output is same as that of the previous condition. So what we have started, we have connected A to plus VCC, that is logic 1, and B is connected to ground, that is logic 0. So conditions are logic 1 and 0 at the input. What we are getting, we are the output is not, and the LED is not glowing, so output is low in this case. So third condition is also satisfied. Now the last condition, that means A is connected to logic 1 and B is also connected to logic 1. A is connected to logic 1, that means it should have to connected to plus VCC. B is connected to logic 1, that means it is also connected to plus VCC. The diodes present between the base to emitter, both are getting positive voltage at P type and N type. That means these diodes are reverse biased. So if reverse bias is there, there will be no current conduction through the emitter. So that is why we say that the transistors are off. Same thing is happening with T1 and as well as T5. So both the transistors here are in off condition. If all the currents is not flowing towards emitter, that means the current will flow towards the collectors. So that way the collectors of both the transistors will have high voltage. These high voltages, they are connected to the parallel transistors T6 and T6, T2 and T6 bases. So high at the basis of both the transistor will turn on this both the transistor. If these two parallel switches or both the parallel transistor, if they are turned on, all the current still is sinking towards ground. So if the currents are sinking towards the ground, collectors of T2 and T6 will have low voltage because the current is sinking, so there will be no drop. So low will be present at the collectors of this transistor. At the same time, all the current is flowing towards the emitter, and that the emitter is connected to 1 kilo ohm resistor. So current is flowing through the resistor, so that will create a voltage, and that voltage we will consider as high because it is more than that of the 0.7 volt. So T3 is getting low voltage at the input and T4 is getting high voltage at the input. So that is why T3, as it is connected to low, it will be off, and T4, as it is connected to high at the input, it will be on. In the previous condition, the same condition is arising here. If these two transistors are connected in series and series connected transistor, if it is off, there will be no current conduction, and thus current through the LED will be zero. If the current is zero, the LED will not glow, and we will see that the LED is off. So off condition is the logic low level. So Y equal to zero is obtained at the output. So if you see, both are connected to plus VCC, that means A is connected to logic 1, B is connected to logic 1. What we are getting? We are getting 0 at the output. So 1, 1, output is 0. So these outputs are same as that of the NOR gate. So this circuit will work as a NOR gate. To remember this circuit, we have to first remember only an inverter circuit. And you can see that from the inverter circuit, we have modified, and that modification made to obtain the transistor as a TTL circuit, as NOR gate and as a NAND gate. Here, what we have to remember? We have to remember only which transistor will be on and which transistor will be off according to the conditions applied at the input. I have explained you how transistors are on and off depending on the logic levels or depending on the voltage present at the input. You have to remember only how transistors are off and on. Then you can summarize this or explain this according to input condition. So before starting that, we have to learn about how these circuits are drawn. If you learn to draw this circuit, the circuit is shown to be very complex, but if you learn it, then you can easily explain it. Starting from the input condition, how the transistors are changing their conditions, and then we can obtain this truth table, and we can manipulate if the outputs are mismatching, then which transistor should be on or off. The main thing is at the output. These are two switches. These are two transistors which are connected in series, and we will call it as a totem pole output. In the totem pole output, what we have to remember, if T3 is on, no current will obtained at the output, and so output will be zero. If T3 is on, then only the current will be present at the output, and output will be one. So if you want output as zero, this should be on. If you want output as one, then this should be on. So you can remember this, and you can explain easily this TTL gate. All the gates explained here, they come for 4 marks, and near about 2.5 marks they are given for the diagrams only, and half mark for truth table, and only 1 mark for explanation. So you can compare that which weightage is given to the circuit diagram. So you have to remember this circuit diagram. Then only you can get out of marks in this topic. So this was all about the TTL gates, and this was NOR gate, TTL NOR gate. After this, we are going to study or discuss about next logic circuit. It is called as a tri-state logic. We will discuss it on the next lecture. Thank you.